This Torah class is brought to you by TorahAnytime.com.
Today we'll speak about the dishwasher. Can we wash in a dishwasher at the same time? Dairy and meat dishes. Let's start from the beginning. What if I'm washing dishes in the sink and they have leftovers? I just finished cooking with the pot meat, and in the other pot I just finished boiled milk, and I'm taking these both pots and I'm putting them in the sink, filling up the sink with hot water. What's going to happen then? Obviously, the leftovers from the meat, if the water is hot, the leftovers of the meat are going to get mixed with the water. And the leftovers from the milk will get mixed also with the water. So now I have in this water, what do I have in this water? Meat and milk together. And since it's hot, it's going to get in the dishes. If the temperature of the water are Yad Soledet Bo, if it's Keli Rishon, if it's not a sink, if it's on top of a fire, if I put a big, huge barrel on a fire, and I'm going to place in this barrel these two pots, what's going to happen then? For sure, Keli Rishon Mevashel, Keli Rishon Mavliya or Mavlit. So now the taste of the meat and the milk that they got mixed will be absorbed also in the dishes. And now the dishes will become zasu, because in the dairy pot I have meat flavor now, and in the meat pot I have dairy flavor. Not only that, the water got both. Now the water has a mix of basar and halav together, and this taste of mixed of basar and halav gets in both dishes. So that's becoming an issue. That's asur to do. On the Keli Rishon, for sure, there is no argument that it's asur to do. On Keli Sheni, it's a mahloket. The sink, obviously, is not considered Keli Rishon. What's the sink is considered? Keli Sheni. What does it mean? Keli Rishon, it's always the kli that stands on the fire. That's called Keli Rishon. Either it's standing on the fire or was standing on the fire. We took it off, but it was on the fire. If it was on the fire, it's called Keli Rishon. But if I took it off the fire, if it was never on a fire, wasn't on a fire, like the sink, so that's called Keli Sheni. The temperature of the water there, if it's hot and high temperature, at least Homshad Soledet Bo, which is approximately 40 degrees Celsius, that's called Homshad Soledet Bo. Some says a little more, 45 degrees, some says a little less. I'm taking the average opinion now. 40 degrees Celsius, that's called Yad Soledet Bo already. Yad Soledet Bo, Keli Sheni, it's not Mevashel and Alachot Shabbat, but it's a Mahloket, it's Mavliya and Maflit. That's a Mahloket. Arama brings in Siman Tzadik Hei Biore Dea, Keli Sheni, it's not Mavliya and not Maflit, and it's not going to become a Asur. That's how the Torah Zahav explains the Rama over there. And even if the dishes has leftovers from the food, it's not going to become asur. Why? Keli Sheni, lo mavliya ve lo maflit. But it's a mahloket. Many poskim hold Keli Sheni, although it's not mevashel, but it's mavliya and maflit. If we'll say that mavliya and maflit, what does it mean mavliya and maflit? That the temperature of the water caused the dishes to discharge and also to absorb. And now what happens? The dishes discharged the flavor of the meat and the dairy and the milk, and now gets also absorbed into the dishes. So therefore, if the dishes are dirty, that's becoming an issue. Obviously, on Keli Rishon, it's for sure an issue. It's asur in Keli Rishon. In Keli Sheni, it's mahloket. The whole concept, it's only if there is no shishim, there's no 60 in the water. But if it's a lot of water and the leftovers of the food, it's very little. You have 60 times in the water more than the leftovers. What's going to be then? But tel b'shishim, it's been canceled. Although you have basar and halaf together, you have basar from the dishes and you have meat, you have milk from the dishes. But how much basar you have? How much meat you put in the sink? It's a tiny bit that got stick to the pot. On the other side also, the milk, how much milk do they have in the pot? Tiny bit. So therefore, if you have a lot of water and there is 60, 60 times more than the milk and the meat in the water, it's being canceled and it's mutar. But if there is no shishim, that's a problem. Why? Now having the water, the taste of basar and halav together, and this taste goes back into the dishes. Now, we have a mahloket among the Rishonim, if the dishes are not dirty with basar and halav, mamash. Maybe you cooked something else in the pot. Maybe you cooked rice in the pot. And you cooked, on the other pot, you cooked pasta. There's no basar and halav over here. Or if the dishes are not dirty, but they were together in the hot water, even keli rishon. That's a mahloket among the rishonim, if that's mutar or asur. Tosafot, Masechet Chulin, Daf Kuf Yud Bet Amud Alef. Tosafot over there says, it's asur. Why? Because the pot has in them the taste of the basar and the taste of the halav. And this taste is being discharged in the water. And the water gets together from the taste of the basar and from the taste of the halav. And that's becoming an issue. There is in the water taste of basar and the halav together, gets back to the dishes, and it's asur. But many Rishonim disagree with this. Haramban, Harashba, Harosh, they disagree. They say it's not considered Ta'am Rishon. It's considered Noten Ta'am Bar Noten Ta'am. You remember last week we spoke about Noten Ta'am Bar Noten Ta'am? We spoke about the rice that you cooked in a Sir Besari. You're allowed to take this rice and eat it with halav. Or the opposite. You cook the pasta in a dairy pot. You're allowed to take this pasta and eat it with basar. Why? It's called Noten Ta'am Bar Noten Ta'am. What does it mean? The meat, the taste of the meat did not get to the pasta directly. It got to the pasta through the pot. First, the meat gave a taste to the pot. Then the pot gave the taste to the pasta. It's already a weak taste. That's called noten ta'am bar noten ta'am. Ta'am sheni. And by the time you're putting the cheese on top of the pasta, it's called ta'am shlishi. So when it comes to the third generation, let's call it this way, it's a 3G. Yeah? If it becomes 3G, noten ta'am bar noten ta'am, it's such a weak taste, it's permitted. It's not a sur. Noten ta'am bar noten ta'am mutar. That's the argument over here. The argument is, Omer Ramban. Ramban is quoting Sefer HaTiruma, who says it's asur. Says Ramban, why it's asur? What's the problem? We're talking about pots that have no meat in them. No meat, no milk. On the previous cook was meat and milk in them. But now they're clean. There's no meat and milk over here. What's the problem? The meat gave the taste to the pot. And the pot gave the taste to the water. What is this water? It's like the pasta. If it was a pasta, I would be able to use this pasta with cheese. I would be able to. It's mutar. Can I boil water in a fleshika pot? Take sir besari, take a besari pot, boil water in this pot, and make coffee with milk. Am I allowed to or not? Mutar. Why it's mutar? Noten ta'am, bar noten ta'am. Bekitzur, in a short way you say, nat bar nat. Nat, rashi tevot, noten ta'am. Bar noten ta'am, meaning it's the secondary taste. Secondary, and many Rishonim consider it third generation, yeah? Third dirty taste. It's a very small, very weak, very, halash, kukach, kalush. The Lashon of the Poskim, it's kalush. Such a weak taste. It's not considered a taste. And therefore it's mutar. That's the rule of noten ta'am bar noten ta'am. Not bar nat. So I can do that. I can take water, boil it in a fleshika pot, yeah, in a meat pot, and use the same water to make coffee with milk. Noten ta'am bar noten ta'am. I can cook pasta in a fleshika pot, and remove it from the pot, and put cheese on top of the pasta. Although it was cooked in a fleshika pot. And same thing, the opposite. I can boil eggs, says Rashba b'tshuva. I can boil eggs in a dairy pot and take these eggs and stuff it in a chicken and roast the chicken like this. The eggs were cooked with a dairy pot, and now I stuff it in a chicken. Mutar. Or I put the eggs in the hamin. After they were boiled in a dairy pot, I take it and I put it in the hamin together with basar. Mutar. Why? Not barnat. So says Ramban, what's the difference? I have two pots mixed in hot water. One is had a taste of basar, the other one has a taste of halav. What happens now? The pot that has a taste from basar gives the taste to the water. And the pot that has this halav gives the taste to the water. What's this water? This water is not the water that I can make coffee with. I can make coffee with milk, with this water. It's not the same as the rice that I cooked in a dairy pot that I want to use with meat. It's the same thing. So therefore, says Ramban, it's not a problem. If the dishes doesn't have the leftovers, mamash, of basar and halav, you can boil it even on keli rishon. Take keli rishon, put basar dishes and halav dishes. No basar and halav mamash, but the dishes of basar and halav. Put it in hot water, boil it together, wash it together, not a problem. So we see a mahloket. Tosafot says it's asur. Sefer HaTerumah says it's asur. Haran agree with them. Also Sefer Mitzvot Gadol says it's asur. Sefer Mitzvot Kasar says it's asur. Sefer Sha'arei Dura says it's asur. They agree with them. But on the other hand, I have a Ramban. Ramban says it's mutar. It's considered not barnat. Arashba followed the Ramban, says it's not barnat, it's mutar. Harosh, Rabbeinu Ashir, followed them, says it's mutar, not barnat. Hatur followed them, says mutar, not barnat. And he says, Rabim Yahronim, Poskim Shaz mutar. Amiri also says not barnat, mutar. So I have many Rishonim saying it's mutar, many Rishonim saying it's asur. The mahloket over here, it's mahloket with the Rabbanan. It's not the Oraita. The Oraita is basar b'halav cooked together. Now it's not really basar b'halav cooked together. It's but no ten ta'am, bar no ten ta'am. Yeah? So since the mahloket the Rabbanan, and most of the Ahronim agreed that it's mutar, says Maran b'Shulchan Aruch, in Bedek Abayit, he says it in Bet Yosef, it's mutar, alacha k'divrei ha-mekelim, also b'Shulchan Aruch, b'siman tzadik hei, b'sa'if gimel, posek Maran, mutar. These dishes, if they were clean, mutar. If it was basar mamash in the water and halav mamash in the water, and now I have basar and halav mixed in the water, that's an issue. I have the taste of basar, I have the taste of halav in a hot water, get mixed, and the taste of the mixture of basar halav goes back to the dishes, becomes asur. Unless I have 60 times in the water more than the basar and the halav. If I have 60 times, which is very possible. All the water what? Cold, beautiful. Cold water also will be mutar. The whole issue of being absorbed into the dishes and also discharged from dishes, it's only in hot water. If the water is cold, no question it's mutar. If the water, it's hot, but I have shishim, I have 60 times in the water more than the basar, the halav, not a problem, it's mutar. It's been canceled in the water. If the dishes were clean, just talking about the taste that absorbs into the dishes from before, that's also mutar, says Maran, even if I don't have shishim. Hot water, no shishim, but it's not barnat, will be mutar also.
The flavor in the pot is considered a secondary flavor, right?
Right.
And then the flavor that absorbs into the water inside the pot is considered a third flavor, tertiary, a third flavor.
Right. The taste in the pot is considered tam rishon.
Right. And then in the water, it's
boiled. In the water, it's tam sheni. When it gets to the halav, it's tam shlishi. Yeah, because the water is still mutar. What I have in the water?
So the pot has the tam rishon.
The pot has tam rishon.
And it goes.
And then
the
it goes to the water, it's tam sheni. And from the water to the halav, that's tam shlishi. That's how you calculate it. So either you say tam sheni, it's enough to say tam sheni, it's mutar, or tam shlishi, but tam shlishi, I'm talking about already when the halal and basar meet each other. That's tam shlishi.
So when you boil the pasta inside of the, or when you cook the pasta inside of the pot, the taste of the meat from the pasta, from the keli...
Taste from the meat from the pot goes to the pasta.
Right. That's
you take the pasta off the pot,
right,
and you put cheese on top of it. Right. Mutar.
But the taste in the pasta right now, it's considered
sheni. Sheni.
Because it comes from the pot.
From the pot.
Because the pot is rishon and this is right to the sheni. So you have
right
tam, and then it's from the. But you have the
then cheese. When you put the cheese on top of it, that's shlishi. The meat goes to the cheese, that's already third degree.
It's coming out of the. It's coming
third
out of
generation.
I got you. Okay.
Okay? Mutar. That's called not barnat, it's mutar. Beautiful. Says Maran, Bebet Yosef, Yiraeli, I can come up with another solution. What's the solution? If you put ashes, ether, if you put ashes in the water, and then you took pots that has leftovers, basar, and pots that have leftovers, halav, and you boil them in a hot water, that would be mutar also. Why? Since the ashes spoils the taste of the basar and halav, and it becomes noten ta'am lifgam, that's mutar, noten ta'am lifgam mutar. And Maran is passing this in Shulchan Aruch. Maran brings this halakha in Shulchan Aruch. Says Maran, Yiraeli, shim natnu efer b'mayim, afilu bekele rishon, afilu yesh mamash basar, mamash halav, batel, mutar. Why? Because it's noten ta'am lifgam. Noten ta'am lifgam mutar. Exactly. So our topic is dishwasher. Dishwasher, and we can take a step back and talk about the sink. You have many houses has still one sink in the apartment, in the house. I remember in the old generation, all the houses in Israel had only one sink. Nobody had two sinks. Everybody used the same sink, basar and halav. How do you do that? So Maran tells us the solution. If you put soap, the soap is even more spoils than ashes. Ashes in the water spoils the water, but it depends how much ashes you put also. But if you put soap, nobody can drink this water. I believe if you give it to a dog, even a dog is not going to be able to drink soapy water. Right? Anybody has a dog here? Did you try ever to give the dog a soapy water? I believe it's not going to drink it. So for sure it's considered pagum. Pagum. What happens now? So even if you have in a sink dairy dishes, meat dishes, but you put soap, and then you fill it up with hot water, even if it was keli rishon, it's not an issue. Same as Maran says, noten ta'am mifgam, noten ta'am mifgam, ubi mutar. Take it now to the next level. New generation, we have dishwashers. How's the dishwasher works? You put the dish, you place the dishes by the racks. Even if you put meat and dairy together, let's review how a dishwasher works. What's the technical details? First, there is the system, the way it works. First, the system sprays cold water on the dishes to remove all the leftovers that stuck to the dishes. Washes it with cold. That's the first wash. Everything, whichever was on the dishes, if it was something that removes easily, was removed already by the cold wash. And then there is a second wash. Second wash comes with hot water. These two systems, these dishwashers that takes hot water from our boiler, from the boiler, and brings it in the dishwasher. It's hot water, it's already keli sheni. But some dishwashers has a guf himum inside, built in. So it boils the water inside. That's keli rishon. The guf hamum is inside the dishwasher, boils the water, and then it spritz it on the dishes. At this time, when the hot water goes on the dishes, the soap goes together with the water. In the door, you put the soap, you press the soap, the door is open, the soap gets mixed with the water, and now the dishwasher spritz soapy water on the dishes. It's very hot, with the soap together, that removes all the dirt from the dishes. So when the water is hot, they mix with soap. What happens now? Even if I have meat leftovers and cheese leftovers in the dishes, the soap spoils it. It's the same as Maran says, if you put effer in the water, it spoils it. Over here also, the soap is going to spoil it. The soap of the dishwasher is stronger than the regular dish soap. It's a very, very strong soap. So this soap in the dishwasher for sure spoils the water, no question, no doubt about that. It spoils the water completely. So now I have, in the water, I have mixed of meat taste and mixed of cheese taste, but everything is spoiled. Now the concern is that this water will be absorbed into the dishes also. But what's absorbed in the dishes? Ta'am pagum. Ta'am pagum, according to Maran, Maran says it's mutar, it's not a problem. Seems like there is no issue to wash in a dishwasher, even at the same time, dairy and meat dishes together. Why? Because it's pagum, noten tam nifgam utam. The question is, if you remember, we spoke about noten tam nifgam in the previous shiurim, and we explained what the Gemara says in the Erev Masechet Avodah Zarah, noten tam nifgam mutar bedi'avad. It's not mutar lechatechila. What does it mean? What is it noten tam nifgam? Let's take an example. I have a meat pot. After 24 hours, what happens with this flavor of the meat in the pot? Becomes pagum. If I took this pot and I cook dairy in this pot, bedi'avad it's mutar. Purposely, I'm not allowed to take this pot and cook dairy in this pot. The gezerah de rabbanan gazru kederabat she'ena bat yuma atu kederabat yuma. Hachamim decree not to cook in this pot even after 24 hours. Although according to the Torah, it's supposed to be mutar. The Torah did not require from us to kosher the dishes only within 24 hours. That the flavor, the taste in the pots is considered noten tam lishvach. Then you're supposed to kosher it according to the Torah. Kelei Midyan. When the Torah says to kosher Kelei Midyan, this is Parashat Pinchas today, right? What happened in Parashat Pinchas? Tzaror et Midyanim v'yikitem otam. Yeah? The Torah commands us to go and on a war against the Midyanim. And then we're going to read later, the next parasha, how Moshe Rabbeinu is going on a war against Midian. They went on a war, Elef Lamateh, they took 12,000 soldiers, they went, they fought, they won the war, they killed all the female, and they brought back a lot of dishes. Shalal, Malkoach, gold, silver, copper, jewelries, everything they took away from the Midianim. So now, after the war, the Torah says, you need to kasher the dishes. Says the Gemara, kashering the dishes, what the Torah is talking about? Same day. Within 24 hours. Then you need to kasher it. 24 hours later, what's going to happen? Automatically becomes mutar. Why? Noten, tam, nifgam. The taste in the pot, it's pagum. Pagum, the Torah did not forbid. Chachamim came and said, listen, kasher it even after 24 hours. Why? Gzera. If you're not going to kasher it after, you might going to get mixed and use it before. So you need to kasher the dishes. It's only the Rabbanan. But Chachamim did not decree to kasher the dishes, only lecha tehillah. Bedi'avad, Chachamim permitted it. And therefore, if I got mixed up and I used by mistake a milchik fry pan. I took a dairy fry pan and I made a schnitzel in this fry pan.
Ben Yomo?
No. If it's Ben Yomo, then what? What's going to happen, Ben Yomo? No, ten tam mishvah. The dairy taste that I cooked the same day, dairy in this fry pan, I did an omelet with cheese. 8 o'clock in the morning, omelet with cheese in this fry pan. 10 o'clock, I took this fry pan, I washed it. I made schnitzel in this pot. What's going to be then? Asur. Why it's asur? It's within 24 hours. So the taste that there is in the pot still considered noten tam lishvach. Noten tam lishvach, it's asur. But if I did it 24 hours later, 8 o'clock, Sunday morning, I cooked the omelet with cheese. 8 o'clock or 9 o'clock Tuesday, I took this fry pan and I made schnitzel with this pot. Then it's noten tam lifgam. Bidiavad mutar. The schnitzel is permitted, you're allowed to eat the schnitzel. Of course, bidiavad. Talking about bidiavad, the chatehila is not allowed to do it. Bidiavad, if you got mixed up, you're allowed to eat the schnitzel. The fry pan needs to kasher. You need to kasher the fry pan. But the schnitzel, you're allowed to eat. Why? It's noten tam lifgam. So, what do we learn from this halacha? That noten tam lifgam is mutar only bidiavad. And now, what are you telling me now? Put soap in the water and put the dishes, dairy and fleishik together and boil it together. That's lechatehila, it's not bidi'avad. How do you permit something like this lechatehila? How Maran, that's a question against Maran. How Maran says put efer in the water and then you're allowed to put both halavi besari together?
There's only a Keli Rishon.
Keli Rishon, talk about Keli Rishon. How Maran permits on Keli Rishon to do noten tam lifgam lechatehila? The all heter of noten tam nifgam is b'di'avad. And over here, Maran says it's mutar. B'chatechila, you're allowed to go ahead and do it. How is this mutar?
Same time, maybe as issue.
Same time. Talking about the same time.
Maybe that's the
same time.
Maybe it's the same time. One doesn't get absorbed over the other. Maybe it's the same time.
Same time should be more hamur, not less hamur. I have basar and halav at the same time in this water. Says Maran, put ashes, mutar. Why? No ten time nifgam. Ya habibi, this is b'di'avad only, and now you're permitting me l'chatechila to do it. How do you permit l'chatechila? Comes Sefer Peritoar, Agaon Rabbi Chaim ben Attar. Last week was his yortzeit, Azkarav Rabbi Chaim ben Attar, or Chaim HaKadosh, and explains Divrei Maran, and says there is a difference at the time the kli absorb. If it absorbs pagum, then it's mutar l'chatechila. The whole idea of noten ta'am nifgam mutar b'di'avad, it's because when the kli absorbed the taste of the isurim, at that time it was good taste. It was noten ta'am nishvah. 24 hours later, it turned into pagum. So that's mutar b'di'avad. But now what are we talking about? That at the time when the kli absorbing, there is in the water basar and halav. This basar and halav, what happens to them? Pagum. Now the kli absorbs, what the kli absorbs? Pagum. If the kli absorbs pagum, mutar l'chatechila. The whole difference between the avad and l'chatechila is if the kli absorbs mishvah. At the time that the kli got from the taste of the isurim, if a goy cooked nevela in this pot. When he cooked it, it was not in ta'am mishvah. Only later on, it becomes not in ta'am nifgam. So there, Chachamim put a decree, said, no, kasher these dishes, don't use it now like this, so you're not going to mix it up with the dishes within 24 hours. But if Me'ikara, when it got absorbed the taste, pagom, no gezerah over here, it's mutar l'chatechila. This is the explanation of Hagaon HaRav Peritoar. The source of this halakha, it's already mentioned in the Rishonim, HaRashba, B'chidushav L'shed Hulin, Daf Kuf Chet, says the Sevara. Rashba talks about kashering dishes after 24 hours. You take a dish that absorbs nevelot. Let's say the goya, the maid in the house, she took the pot and she cooked not kosher hot dogs in this pot. What happened with this pot now? Asur. There is a nevelot. Yeah? Okay. I need to kasher it. What do I need to do? I need to dip it in hot water. Boil water, keli rishon, on the fire, and put this dish in the water. What's going to happen now? The taste of the nevelot that absorbed into the pot goes into the water. Goes into the water, and now it's hot. What's going to happen? It's going to go back to the dish. So how you kashering it exactly? So there are some poskim says you need 60 pe'amim b'mayim k'neged hakli. You gotta get such a big barrel that in this barrel has so much water, 60 times more than the pot. So now what happens? It's been canceled in 60. You're canceling it by 60. Okay. But what if you do it after 24 hours? So it's pagum, says HaRashba, after 24 hours you don't need 60. Even if it's a little bit of water, the taste in the pot is already pagum. It goes into the water, and therefore, since it's pagum, it's not going to be asur. HaRashba himself is asking, what's going on? Let's do the math. In this pot, there is tam nevelot. What's this tam? Is pagum, right? It's tam pagum. Why are we talking about the next day, 24 hours later? The time is pagum. What are you telling me? Kasher it. Okay, I take it. Put it in a hot water. In the water, what do I have now? Tam pagum. This tam pagum, what happens with this tam pagum? There's no shishim. So what happens now? Goes back to the pot. So same tam pagum was in the pot, went out to the water, and got back to the pot. So why do I need to do this? What's the purpose of kashering the dishes 24 hours later? If I have shishim, I understand. If I don't have shishim, it's the same pagum that was in the dishes. got into the water, got back to the dishes. Ma, this is yo-yo game. What are you doing over here? What are you gaining by kashering the dishes after 24 hours?
It came in the gun.
Beautiful.
The first time it came in the
Chazako Baruch, that's the explanation of Arashba. Says Arashba, the difference is the tam pagum in the dishes. Originally, what was it? It was tam nishvah. And since it was nishvah in the beginning, and then it turned into pagum, there is Gezerat Rabbanan, don't use these dishes. You have to kasher it. Now that you're kashering it, and it's pagum in the water, the kli now absorbs. What it absorbs now? Tam pagum. If it absorbs tam pagum, it's not asur. That's mutar lechatechila. So same svara of Sefer Peritoar, we see in Arashba. Peritoar, Agon Behemel Atar, was about 200 years ago. 300 years ago. Arashba talking about 700 years ago. Yeah? That's a Rishonim. Same svara that we see in Arashba says Haran, Masechet Psachim Daf Lamed, and also Masechet Chulin Daf Kuf Het, Psugiyat Tipat Halav Shenafla Ala Basar. Same svara. Same svara says Ha-Meiri also, Bechidushav Lemasechet Avodah Zara Daf Ayin Vav. There is a difference if the Kli absorb in the beginning good taste and then it turned Pagum, that's Asur. Or if the kli absorbed in the beginning, pagum. If it absorbed in the beginning, pagum, it's mutar even lechatechila. And many achronim follow this svara and agree with what the rishonim are saying. Sefer Knesset Agdola, Agon Rabbi Chaim Ben Ishti, he lived about 350 years ago in Turkey. He says, Sefer Damesek Eliezer, Sefer Lechem Apanim, they agree with Maran, but I don't see this opinion. I don't see this svara. How Maran permit to put effer in the water? To put effer in the water, the only eter it's not 10 times lifgam, not 10 times lifgam mutar only b'di'avad. That's question of Knesset Gdola. But all the achronim came, and they were mechalek, they were metaretz the kushya of Knesset Gdola, the same as Sefer Peritoar was metaretz. Among these achronim, you have Rav Hida b'Sefer. Sefer Berkei Yosef ביורד יעב סימן צדיק היי. You have also הגאון רבי אליהו ישראל בשאלות ותשובות כל אליהו בחלק א'. You have also one of גדולי אלג'יר רבי יהודה עייש בספר בית יהודה. גדול רבני בבל רבי עבדאללה סומך בספר סביחי צדק. הגאון רבי חיים פלאג'י. And many more אחרונים all agree with מרן. They said what מרן said over here זה ברב קודש קודשים. Also, Sefer Shelot Utshuvot Tzemach Tzedek Shelubavitch also brings this Mahloket, and he says Ein lanu ela divrei ha-shuhan aruch Asher ruach Hashem diber bam U'milato al leshonam. Maran says it's mutar because it's noten ta'al mifgam. Divrei Maran Kodesh Kodashim. And Hagaon Rabbi Yehuda Ayash B'Sefer Bet Yehuda also brings this Mahloket. And his conclusion, noten tam nifgam, if it absorbs the pagum, it's mutar lechatechila. He talks over there about a very interesting situation. If you took by mistake a spoon, dairy spoon, and you stack it in a soup with meat, if it's ben yomo, same day, in the morning, you use this spoon to mix the boiled milk. Ben Yomo. You washed it. And by mistake, you took it and you mixed the soup with the meat now. What's the halakha now?
Shishim or no?
You need shishim. You need shishim against the spoon. Now, it says like this. If this spoon was washed in Keli Rishon, on top of the fire, together with meat, but with ashes, as Maran says in Shulchan Aruch, what happens to these spoons now? It's like kashering it. It's like a gala. What happened there? It was Keli Rishon, on top of the fire. You put the spoon inside, it was broiled. There is ashes in the water. So now the dairy, the meat, everything got mixed with these ashes. all becomes pagum, and the kli absorbs now what? Pagum. And now you took this spoon and you mix the soup. It was originally dairy spoon. It was washed together with the ashes. And now you took it and you mixed the soup with the meat. Says the Gaon Rabbi Ayash, mutarim lachem, mutarim lachem, echolim lachem, mutar. You can go ahead and eat it. Why? The spoon absorbs tam pagum. And what was in the spoon, originally, the milk that absorbed in the spoon, it was discharged, and this mayim pegumim was hot water, pagum, was a process of agala. That's a process of kashering. It's the same as kashering it. So now this spoon has a tam pagum in it. Tam pagum, you can use it with whichever one you want. You can use it with dairy, you can use it with flesh. That's the hiddush of agon with ayash. And many poskim agree on this opinion. Agon Rav Moshe Feinstein, Beigrot Moshe Helek Bet, Siman Samech Bet, Biyoredeha, Helek Bet, Biyoredeha, Siman Samech Bet, he also talks about the dishwasher. And he over there says, if the soap is a strong soap, and it's for sure pogem the water, there is a very strong halachic base to permit everything. But he comes with a comment, he says, maybe people will do it with no soap. If they're going to use dairy and meat dishes in the dishwasher with no soap, then it's not pagum, that will become an issue and it's a soap. So therefore, the conclusion of Agon Moshe Feinstein, lechatechila, you shouldn't use both at the same time. So people should not mix it up and use the dishes in the dishwasher with no soap. There is a teshuva in Yabia Omer. Maran Rabbeinu Avadei Yosef, Helek Yud, Yoredi'a Siman Dalet. Talks about the dishwasher. He quotes the poskim that we mentioned, Gemara, the poskim. And his conclusion, since Maran, Shulchan Aruch tells us, if you put ashes in the water, you can use both dairy and meat dishes, even with leftovers, together with this hot water. And Lanu Ela Divrei Maran. The Sfaradim accepted upon themselves Horaot Maran Abet Yosef. And we have so many Ahronim that agree with Maran. Gedolei Rabbanei Sfarad, they agree with Maran. Therefore, says Agon Rabbi Avadei Yosef, Mutar to use in a dishwasher dairy and meat dishes at the same time with soap. And it brings Agon Rabbi Moshe Feinstein that says, maybe people will make a mistake and use it with no soap. It's very rare. Nobody uses dishwasher with no soap. Most likely people use it with the soap. And therefore, to come up with a new gezerah like this, as we know, we don't have the power to do gezerot hadashot. Therefore, the conclusion of Maran Rabbeinu Avadei Yosef, that it's permitted. Lechatechila, if a person has, anyway, many dishes that he wants to wash, and he can do it in two cycles, anyway, he wants to do two cycles, yeah, lechatechila, better to do it separately. And one after another, everyone agreed that it's mutar. You can use the same dishwasher. First cycle for dairy dishes. Second cycle, meat dishes. Lechatechila, no question it's mutar. The hidush of Rabbi Avadei Yosef, that not only one after another it's mutar, but also at the same time it's mutar. Lechatechila, mahmir tavo ala biracha. If you do it in two cycles, that's a humrah tavo ala biracha. And for sure, if it got mixed, by mistake, no question, mutar. The dishes are mutar, and the dishwasher is still mutar. You don't need to do any kashering process after it. Why? The soap spoils the water, and it absorbs in pagum. Maran is paskin, that is mutar. Baruch Adonai le'olam. Amen v'amen. Rabbi Hanan Kasha Omer, Ratzah HaKadosh Baruch Hu Lezakot Et Yisrael.
You've just experienced another Torah class brought to you by TorahAnytime.com.